Hi guys, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session we will check the difference between the sum and sum max in Power BI functions. Before that, we must check the calculation engine in Power BI. There are two types of the calculation engines. One is the aggregators and other is the iterators. When you use the functions like the average, minimum, max and count, those functions are called the aggregators, or they calculate aggregation. In case of the aggregator functions, they scan the single column. They scan the whole values in single column and then process that. But in case of the iterators, the function which ends with the x characters are called the iterator functions. And these functions process the data row by row. And in that processing, you can add your own logic. Let us check the actual difference between the sum and sumx in Power BI. Sum is the aggregators and sumx is the iterators. Already we know what is the aggregators and what is the iterators. The purpose of both function is to add the numerical data. In case of the sum, it scan the single column, means it scan the whole cells, whole value of a single column, then sum up all the values and produce the scalar value. In case of this sum max, it does the same thing but with additional logic. If you see the syntax of the sum max, there are two parameters. One is the table and other one is the expression. It means this sum max is more powerful than the sum, because in case of the sum max, you can also add some additional logic, or you can add additional filter in the expression. So this is the major difference between the sum and sum max. In sum max, you can add more logic, but in case of the sum, you can't. As I told you, sum is the aggregator and the sum max is the iterators. What is the actual difference in functionality or processing of the data? In case of the sum, it scans the whole column, all the values of the cells like this, and then add the values and calculate the total. But in case of the sumx, it works like a loop. It starts reading the first row and goes up to the last row. Suppose in sumx we have an expression and we calculate the profit, gross sale minus net sales. Then first row gross sale minus first row net sales. Then second row, third row, fourth row. So sumx processes the data row by row. This is the major difference between the sum and sumx. Let us check the actual difference between the sum and sumx in Power BI with practical. But first of all, we have some data in Excel sheet, sales data. So we check that data. We have the country, product, quantity sold, year of sales, unit price, gross sales and net sales. But the profit column is missing. So how to calculate the profit? Gross sale minus net sales. Now, so we will calculate the profit using the sum and sumx, then we'll check what is the actual difference between two. Now, we check the actual difference between the sum and sumx. So in the right side, you can see we have the table, that is the sales summary. We have seen the data. If we go to the data, then we have the gross sales and net sales. So we have to calculate the profit. First of all, we calculate a total gross sales. So we are not interested in creating a new column in this data model. So we will create a measure. New measure. Gross sales. Now execute. So you can see in the right side the measure added in the table. Now we check this measure in data table and drag and drop. First of all, product, then measure. So you can see we have a table and we have taken the product and the new created measure, that is the measure total gross sales. So measure works in the filter context. That's why you can see the sales product wise. In CPU, this is the gross sales. For hard disk, this is the gross sale. Now, we create another measure, profit. So this time we are calculating the profit in a measure and we are using a sum. So we are deducting the net sales from the gross sales. Now execute. So you can see in the right side one more measure added. That is the measure of profit. Means we calculate the profit using the sum max. Then we'll check what is the difference between two. You can see when we use the sum max, so we have to supply two parameters. First of all, table name, that is the sales summary, then comma expression. Expression is gross sales minus net sales. So this is kind of the filter as the expression. Execute. Okay. So you can see one more measure created, that is the measure sum max and measure sum. Now we check. So already we have the measure total gross sales. Now we put measure sum, then sum max. Measure sum and measure sum max using the figure are the same. Because both are measures and both work in the filter context, so you can see the profit product wise, CPU, hard disk, keyboard. Then what is the difference between two? The difference is this profit, this sum, is calculating the value on the basis of the column, and this is calculating the value of the row wise, and this is the sum. In case in this situation, the sum x is the best approach, not this one. So if you need more filter, if you need additional filter, then you must use the sum max. Let us check those formulas we used for this practical. The first one was the total gross sales and we used the sum and we took the sales summary gross sales and we created the measure for all these three formulas. And we know the measure works in the filter context by default automatically. The second function was the profit calculation. For this purpose, we use the sum, then single column, then minus again sum, then net sales. For the same purpose, we use the sum max. But in case the sum max, first of all, we have the table name, then we have an expression. Gross sales minus net sales. These two functions did the same thing. We achieved the like profit, but the sum max, in this case, the sum max is the best approach for this kind of scenario. So guys, this was all about the difference between the sum and sum x. I hope you understood everything. Thanks for watching the video.